Hey guys, today we're checking out one of the remixes of Hypa Hypa. This one's with WBTBWB. I want to say that stands for We Butter the Bread with Butter. I think that's the name of the group. I don't really know too much about them, but I know that this song's been getting a lot of hype. It looks like a lot of fun, so we're gonna check it out. This is already ridiculous, like right off the bat. The combination of the smiling face with the just gurgling vocals. This is like off the wall. This is disgusting. You know, the vocals, they kind of remind me of, Mitch Flecker. Somehow. This part is so ridiculous. The like, the double bass and the like game vocal happy chanting. Big time, like 2008, like crunkcore vibes. Attack, attack, you know. Great Carolina, stuff like that. This is ridiculous. I can still hear the original in here, but this is so different. Ooh, I like this part. We're done. Alright, that was Eskimo Cowboy and WBTBWB. Hypa Hypa. Let's talk about that. Man, that was a really, really interesting song. Just off the walls ridiculous in every aspect. Just the vocals were just so filthy. And going along with like the kind of like pop dance music lyrics. It's just hilarious. The delivery of the vocals in contrast to the smiling faces in the video. So, so funny. It was cracking me up the whole time. And they also reminded me of Mitch Lucker from Suicide Silence, kind of that witchy kind of high that he does. It kind of reminded me of that a little bit. The drummer, who I'm sure is a computer, just like absolutely pounding the double bass the entire time. Super funny. But also really, really groovy. The overall vibe and tone of this song reminded me of those crunkcore bands from 2008-ish, you know, when everyone was wearing bling and the shutter shades and the neon cartoon monster merch t-shirts, you know, bands like Attack Attack. Not that Attack Attack was crunkcore, they're more crabcore, but you know what I mean. Those bands that would incorporate EDM and dance melodies into these super, super heavy breakdown, heavy songs. Is it something that I'm going to listen to every day? Probably not. I just prefer music that's a little bit more introspective, that takes itself a little bit more seriously. But I can definitely see myself putting this into the shuffle or a playlist somewhere. I actually prefer it to the original, I think. Something about the delivery of the vocals and the instrumentals and the breakdowns, I like it better than the original, I think. But what do you think? Let me know in the comments. Do you prefer this to the original? Which of the remixes are your favorites? I know there's a couple out there, and they're releasing an EP of all the remixes, I think. So yeah, let me know which one is your favorite, and that's gonna do it for me today. Till the next one, I'll see you around. What do you guys think of this new setup? I was doing it in the living room for a little bit. I did a couple videos in a studio with like the kind of colored lights and the black background. I think I prefer this. This is a little more personality. It's easier to film because that black background is super hard to color correct for, and I look like a ghost when I against the black background, especially with, you know, all my black band merch and things like that, my dark hair. So yeah, let me know what you think. I think this is probably where I'm going to be filming most of the videos from now on. So yeah, let me know.